In order for anybody to be rich, somebody gotta be poor. You know, I grew up in the crack era, and crack really hit New York, so it changed the whole landscape of everything. But what happened? I thought we was going to Rikers Island, and he just laughed and said, "This is Rikers Island."
Yeah, How It Happened podcast out in QU. They were my QU soldiers, and we just did a good exclusive LAZ.
Don't believe the shit you hear. Don't believe the shit everybody telling you. To how the hell you get a Jim Jones verse? And we turn that shit into a video that just got played on MTV Jams.
What was one of the craziest things you seen in prison?
Man, I seen a lot of shit, bro. I seen a lot of shit, man. I mean, a whole lot of shit. One of the worst things I probably saw was, I spoke about it on my channel before, was when I seen dudes throw some hot ass grease on a dude's face while he was asleep, man.
That's fucked up. I mean,
the dude had cut somebody real, real bad on Rikers Island. And he just so happened to have landed in the dorm, same dorm with the dude that he cut. And the dude that he cut basically pretended that he didn't recognize him. And he let the dude stay there for like 2-3 days, but the dude was suspicious because he would never come out his cube. You know, up in this facility, it's like a big dorm with cubicles and little walls in between each cubicle. So you have somewhat some privacy. But when you stand up, you see everybody. But when you lay down, you got some privacy. You know what I mean? So dude was playing his bed for days. He wouldn't do nothing but go to the bathroom and back. And after like the third or fourth day that he was there, like, you know what I mean? Dude's boy was some oil. Because they used to have metal hot pots, like coffee pots. So dudes boiled some oil for like 40 minutes. That shit was bubbling. And I mean, when they called the count and the CO went to go check the bathroom to make sure nobody was in the bathroom, the dorm is the dorm has no CO in it for about 2 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
And while he did that, they walked past his cube, yanked the blanket off of him, and just threw the hot grease in his face. Right? And that shit kind of melted his whole face off.
Insane.
He was smart enough not to wipe his face. I don't know how he did that. Like, to this day, I don't know how he resisted wiping his face.
Because then everything would come off.
Everything is coming off, you wipe it. So he knew better than to wipe his face. And he didn't wipe his face. And he laid back down. Like, dude was a thorough dude, bro. Because he laid That's back crazy. Down. He didn't tell the cops nothing.
Nah, what?
He laid back down. And he stood in his cube for about 2-3 hours. And his shit was maybe not 2-3 hours, maybe an hour. And his shit was bubbling. You heard? And he couldn't take it no more. He eventually went up to the police and told him, yo. He said, yo. Police turned around. He had the lights out. And he tapped on the police desk. He was like, yo, I need to go to the hospital. He said, what happened? He said, I was cooking in my cube and the hot pot fell on me and it splashed me in my face.
Some real shit. He ain't even.
And he was like, let me see. And he turned the light on. Police almost jumped out his damn seat because the kid's face was swole up like this. You feel me? Like, shit was bubbling, blisters all over his face. And police just pulled the pin, like, called the emergency unit or whatever, and they got the kid out of there. Kid ain't tell on nobody. Heard, because he knew what he did. But that was some real shit, and I still to this day don't know how that dude resisted wiping his face.
Yeah, that's crazy.
It would have been instinct to wipe my face
straight up, and that shit would have took all his skin off.
Hell yeah.
You know, that same thing happened in another dorm in the same jail, and he did wipe his face and his shit came off.
Jeez. That was normal. People cooking up some hot grease.
They banned them shits though. Like, after, you know, after a few years more of that, they completely banned them where you can't get them in. But the thing was, it was a loophole. If you already had one, they really couldn't take it from you. So it would be like one or two of them on the compound. and dudes would get their hand on them on the metal shits. Eventually, they turn them into plastic, so you can't boil no grease in there. Mm. But, you know, dudes was boiling grease in the microwave too, bro. Like, dudes would put some grease into a bowl and just put it in the microwave for a couple of minutes, and that shit be burning hot. You heard? So, you know, that grease shit is crazy.